With me on Skype today from K2fly, I'm joined by Brian Miller. Brian, good to see you. Good morning.
Good morning to you, Andrew.
Look, a couple of big deals to catch up on, Brian. Firstly, the AngloGold Ashanti plus Newmont. A couple of big names here. Tell us more.
Yeah, in fact, the last two or three weeks have been pretty special for us, Andrew. A couple of weeks ago, we did some deals with Vale and South 32. And for obviously people with a resources background, they're very good names. We then followed it up with Newmont, the world's largest gold producer. And I guess the most recent one is AngloGold Ashanti, another very big gold player. The interesting thing about AngloGold Ashanti is that they've signed up for a three-year deal. They were existing clients of K2fly, but they decided they wanted the sort of the security and predictability of going for a three-year deal. So they're good names, and they've come on the back of other companies such as Gold Fields and Rio Tinto in the last 3 months. So yeah, pretty pleased with the way things are going at the moment, Andrew.
Brian, we can't avoid talking about coronavirus and the impact it's having. What precaution are you guys taking at the moment?
Yeah, it is an interesting point. And obviously the various stock markets of the world have been significantly impacted. I want to say we're in the right place at the right time. We're very fortunate. We are growing our so-called software as a service business, which is in effect where clients are renting the software off us. It's our own intellectual property. And the really good thing about that, and it is more by luck than judgment, that it doesn't require a whole heap of implementation services taking place on a client site. We have to do implementation, but a lot of it is done remotely. We have clients in Canada and France and Brazil where maybe there was a 10-man day effort of somebody actually being on site, but the vast majority of it can be done remotely, which is fantastic. Other software and services companies will be having issues at the moment. I know of a lot of big clients, big firms who are saying, hey, we don't want to see your contractors anymore. We don't want to see your staff anymore. They're sending a lot of their own staff home to be working from home. So yeah, it is pretty fortunate, and we're very pleased to be in the software as a service game, because clearly that's the high margin money. And thankfully in this current emergency, it doesn't require a lot of that on-site consultancy.
So can we expect more of these SaaS deals to come, Brian, in the coming weeks and months?
Yeah, I hope so, Andrew. So we had a team at the PDAC conference in Canada a couple of weeks ago, the world's biggest mining conference, 23,000 delegates, a pretty big affair. Clearly, until I get a purchase order in my hand or a signed contract, nothing is true until you get that. But we're in advanced negotiation with some big players, some big miners, who are being forced in part by the changes in the SEC regulations for the New York Stock Exchange that they have to get a system such as ours. So thankfully, coming out of PDAC, there are several opportunities, and hopefully we're going to be successful with some of those. The financial year end in Australia is June 30th. And yeah, I'd like to be thinking you and I will be doing a few more interviews in the next few weeks and months.
Looking forward to it. Brian, thanks very much.
No, thank you, Andrew. Thanks for your time.